The following is a special multimedia presentation from NorthJerseySports.com, sponsored by The Anvil. Let us introduce you.
Hi, welcome to The Anvil.
Let's get started on the tour, shall we?
This is our designated area for warm-ups, calisthenics, abs, and stretching. Dan, maybe jeans aren't the best idea.
If I can't get ripped, at least my jeans will. We have 60 by 100 feet of turf area for you to practice with your team or play with your friends. We have parties and field rentals. We can do basketball, baseball, softball, hockey, lacrosse, or the age-old gym favorite, dodgeball.
To all of our clients, even those who are not currently working out, especially the moms. Enjoy.
Thank you. Here at the Anvil, we have the sleds to help you shred. Isn't that right, Tom?
Back on the ball game here on NorthJerseySports.com under strange circumstances here at the headquarters of NorthJerseySports.com. I am Corey Doviak, being joined by Ramapo head coach Sandy Gordon. Sandy, thanks for joining us here on the ball game.
Thanks for having me, Corey.
Yeah, this is crazy. Now let's just break this down. I didn't go to the game tonight. Tonight was the first, Group 3 state semifinals at your high school. It's just the way it worked out. The Group 3 semifinals are always at Ramapo High School. This year you happen to be in it. So for the first time in your tenure there and in the history of the girls' basketball program, and it turned out to be a 55-48 win over Warren Hills. I want to talk about the game first. I mean, we're going to talk about the strange circumstances, the empty gym, you know, all those other things, but people can get that kind of talk anywhere at this type of moment.
Right.
Where it's all over every, you know, website, et cetera, all over the place. So let's talk about some basketball first. 55-48 over Warren Hills. You know, it's got to be just great for you. I was there the other night when you won your first state sectional title, the program's first state sectional title, and then to take it one step further tonight. Talk about that first, you know, advancing to the Group 3 finals, if there is one.
Correct. I mean, you know, again, it's that march, you know, survive in advance. And, you know, we didn't play our best tonight, but we found a way. We made enough plays, and it was the right side of the scoreboard. You know, so again, we're super excited. You know, we beat the most wins, in a season this year also. So another little record for this group. So, you know, super excited. It's the unknown of what tomorrow brings.
Yeah. So you might as well live in the moment. You had a game to play today. They let you play the game today. You played the game today and you won. Put the pressure on them to call it off. You don't do it, right? Is that the mindset?
Well, right. You know what? Like I told our kids, because obviously, you know, we weren't necessarily focused, you know, everyone, you know, are we playing, aren't we playing, fans allowed, not allowed, you know, so we were all consumed with that, you know, and then obviously the virus, it's crazy, we all know that. And I just said, hey, you know, thankfully we have a superintendent and an AD, you know, that were supportive of us playing it, and, you know, let's seize the moment, and, you know, you're in your gym, and let's, you know, who cares, everyone's watching it live stream, and just go out and do what you got to do.
Yeah, so talk about the game. I mean, I know it was 25-25. We should mention, too, you know, we were having updates here on NorthJerseySports.com. There was a mole in the gym who was passing us along some information so that we could tweet it out. Rumor has it that mole might even have been sitting on your bench, but we don't need to mention any names. But I know from the information that was passed along to us, it was 25-25 at half, and then you wound up, you know, winning 55-48. So what changed in the second half there, where you guys were able to forge in front and hang on?
You know, they're a tough, gritty, physical team, and, you know, state semifinal, and the referees let you play, and, you know, we had kind of had to match their physical part a little bit. We were a little soft at times. And, you know, we just, they changed up their D. We changed up their D. We went, you know, man, zone, back to man. And, you know, we made enough plays and, you know, we got into the bonus and we made foul shots down the stretch to, you know, to give us a little bit of a, you know, little cushion. It wasn't much. It was back and forth every possession. You know, we harp on that all year. You know, we got to get those 3 points from the foul line. You know, if we're struggling to generate it, and you know, we did. We made enough plays, and you know, it was a battle. It was a tough, hard fought win.
You know, I was gonna say like who played well for you, but having seen you on multiple occasions this year, I know it's anybody's turn. It's not a matter of, you know, we need this girl to play well. It's just a matter of, you know, this game calls for this situation and this player. I mean, I thought the other night in the state sectional final against a real good Sparta team, I want to talk about that too, but I thought Savannah Ring had some big points. I thought Julia Corella was great. Madison Schiller as well. I mean, yeah. Really, you got contributions from everybody. How about tonight? I mean, whose turn was it in the situation that you were in?
It's the same story. You know, we are so unselfish. We share the ball. Everyone has to do their part, do their job. And it was no different tonight. You know, Madison, you know, led us with 23. Lauren Actor had 15. Ring had her 9. Julie had her 8. You know, a couple key rebounds from Fatten here. You know, Alexa came off the bench late, had a big steal. You know, so everyone kind of did their thing, and that's why we're still playing. Hopefully we can play one more game, but, you know, it's what we've done all year. Right? We, you know, put up on the board, got to play 4 quarters. Everyone's got to do their part. Give us something. And today the bench was, their job was to be the cheerleaders and make some noise and act like there was a big crowd. And they were deafening. Like, it was like giving me a headache, but it was all good.
That's great. It really, let's get back to that state sectionals final, the North 1 Group 3 state sectional final that was played on, what was that now, on Tuesday night. That was the first one. And I was going back and writing the story, and then I was just, you know, listening to the quotes that you had given me. I mean, I thought it was so great when you said that, you know, it wasn't about you. You've had your time, and that these kids deserve, you know, to break. This is the group that broke through. And it's the group that you've been looking forward to for a long time. You know, you got 0 seniors on the roster. You have 2 juniors in the starting lineup, yep. And then everybody else is sophomores and freshmen. And you know, people don't realize because the group in front of them is so strong. But this freshman class that you have is good and will be great as you go forward too. So how about seeing all this come to fruition? You know, from when we talked, I remember you getting on the bus. I saw you in the school. You were getting on the bus to go scrimmage Chatham, and we chatted briefly. And you know, looking forward to big things this year. And now, whatever it is, 4 months later. And you're one of the last few teams in the state left standing. Have you been able to put it into context yet?
Not really, but, you know, it's a special group, obviously. And for me, it started back in the fall when we, you know, were choosing what, like, fall league to play in. And I was like, we could just keep it easy, be right here. We usually play at Saddle River Day, you know, right in our backyard. It's just more convenient, blah, blah, blah. Or I said we could challenge ourselves and go to West Orange and get out of our comfort zone and get a little more competition. And they were all about it. That's what they wanted, and, you know, and that's what we did. And we played a lot of different teams. And for me, it started there. And then for the whole program, truthfully, I had so many kids, you know, and then I had the JV and freshmen playing, you know, over Saddle River Day in that little fall league. And, you know, they've all bought in. And all the hard work that they've put in, it's paying off.
Yeah, and it's good to see, too, because, you know, and I'm sure, you know, people who cover other teams around the state and go on these runs with them, you know, where they see them succeed, they, you know, guys in my business always say, you know, what a good group of kids. But, you know, I don't know every other team in the state. I do know your team.
Right.
And, you know, I've had a lot of fun with this group, too. I mean, just, you know, watching them grow and watching them play here. So, you know, it's got to be. I thought Julia Corella was great, too, the other day when I interviewed her after the game. She was saying, you know, I don't score a lot, but this was kind of a game where I needed to score some points. And she did. And no one then looks at her and says, wow, you're taking too many shots. You're a ball hog. They just kind of said, okay, it's Julia's kind of night. So
exactly. She was open.
How much. Yep. Go ahead. Sorry.
She was open and, you know, hit the shots. And she did a little bit of that tonight. And, you know, her job is always to guard the best kid. And, but again, like, we share the ball. If you're open, it's, you know, you have the green light to shoot it within our, you know, it's a good shot. And they know that. And they're willing to give it up and make the extra pass. And, you know, they just click and gelled, and they don't really care who gets their name in the paper. And, you know, at the end of the day, you got the trophy, and that's what you wanted. So,
yep.
You know, it's just ironic, you know, all these years we've been working, you know, we worked this round, you know, we finally get a chance to play in our own gym, and this, you know, this happens. So like I told him after the game, I'm like, you will never forget this game the rest of your life. This will be a story that you will talk about. you're getting to play in a state section or a state semifinal in an empty gym. It's something you're going to talk about. And you won.
How empty was empty?
It was empty. Besides from, you know, our personnel and a couple of their people, and, you know, it was empty. Worse than a scrimmage, because, you know, in a scrimmage you have some parents in there, but, you know.
Yeah.
We had about 300 people watching it live stream, and most of our parents were over at a local bar. They put it up on the TV for them, and, you know, they had a blast with it.
Yeah. No, it's cool. I mean, it's, you know, making lemonade out of lemons, as they say. But I want to quickly go back to, because, you know, you have such a young group, and then that state sectional final that I watched the other day, that Sparta team is four freshmen in the starting lineup. That girl, Bryn McCurry, was...
Fabulous.
And you know, the pick and roll, which I wrote about a lot in my story. But, you know, I see a nice little rivalry budding here over the next couple of years between you and them. I mean, not that you're thinking about that now. At that point, I'm sure you're glad they're in the rearview mirror. But, you know, that's a squad that kind of mirrors your own. Have you, you know, given a second thought to Sparta and the times you may see them coming up in the next couple of years here?
Yeah, we you know, hopefully we're seeing them a lot in, you know, the finals and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, absolutely, they were a very good team. They're tremendous. Those kids are young. The post players lights out, and you know, we knew what they were going to run. We had to defend it, and obviously we struggled at times. And so I think we're going to have some battles moving forward.
All right, last one, and then I'll let you get out of here. I know you've had a busy night and a busy week and a crazy week and a surreal week and all that other stuff though. But what have you heard? You know, it seems to change by the minute here. Plans for the Group 3 final. Do you think you're going to play? Where are you going to play? And what's going on?
My gut says no. We're still hopeful that, you know, because we did it like this with no fans and you can live stream it so that people to watch, so maybe just the teams can go and play. It's really off the state. I know we have a regular school day tomorrow, and then we are closed until further notice. So... I highly doubt it, but it's really in the state's hands or the board, you know, of health is, you know, call. Hopefully we're going to play it and just, again, no fans and spectators allowed and just the two teams and the personnel, but it's still, no final word has come through yet.
Sandy Gordon, the head coach of the state semifinal winning Ramapo Green Raiders. Congratulations on the win. And yeah, I mean, hopefully we will be around long enough to be talking about this craziness in years to come, too. And we could tell the future teams that come through in a couple years. I remember the year that, you know, when we point to the banner up there and say, remember that year? It was crazy. So hopefully this too shall pass. And good luck if you do play. And if not, congratulations on a great season.
Great. Thanks, Corey. I appreciate all the coverage and all the good stuff you do.
Thanks.
Follow the leader.